historic run to go 18-0. First SWAC team to go 18-0 in conference play as we are ready to go in Baton Rouge. And Jackson State and their starting lineups are brought to you by Capital One. They get the first possession of the game and the first score. Our Capital One starting lineups for LSU. Pointer, Ryan Payne still starting for Alexis Morris. Cherry, Newby, as well as Afua. And Deja Rogan, who was last year's player of the year in the SWAC, missing on that three-pointer. Jackson State, 23-6 on the year, 18-0 in conference play, and they challenged themselves this year with a very tough non-conference schedule.
Well, they did. They play a lot of Power Five teams, did a great job, lost, but got the experience. I think the most they lost was with Texas by 13, so that just gives your team just some experience and understand what this game needs to be all about.
Yeah, they're excited to come in here to the PMAC and play against LSU. They played against a Kim Mulkey coach team last year in the NCAA championship as they played Baylor in the first round last year after winning the SWAC tournament championship. This year they are sent as the number 14 seed to play LSU. Cherry off the screen, the first basket for LSU.
Well, good sign for LSU scoring from the outside using the screen and got an easy look to the basket.
Tishana Luckett handling the ball up top. Deja Rogan, you are going to enjoy watching this young woman play. So quick to the basket, she misses that time.
Yeah, really quick to the basket, and that's what she needs to do. She needs to drive hard.
Khayla Pointer misses, but Rogan knocks it out of bounds.
And both teams just a little, this is first game for both teams. It's just a little tight, little, you know, the adrenaline's flowing a little bit. They'll settle in.
Kim Mulkey watching on. There's a lot of things going on in Baton Rouge today and this weekend, a St. Patrick's Day parade. LSU baseball is going on campus this weekend, and Kim Mulkey just said, but could you all just come over and just watch some basketball today?
Kim said, it's about women's basketball, so, and they have shown up in forces.
Jailin Cherry with the jumper. Luckett too strong, but a great rebound. Maya Crump, the transfer from Houston, couldn't convert.
And Jackson State is getting good looks. It's just not going down right now.
There she is, Williams Holiday. Such a force on both ends of the court with that rebound. We mentioned the tough non-conference schedule and how Jackson State has challenged themselves. How does that prepare them for this game?
Well, it prepares them for this environment. It prepares them for the speed, the athleticism that they've got to defend, the height, the strength, and just the pace.
Maya Crump commits the foul, and the Power Five opponents we've been talking about, they didn't get any wins, but you don't see really any blowouts on that list.
Well, you don't, and you look, Brendan, Miami's in the tournament. Ole Miss now out. They were in the tournament. Texas is in the tournament. Arkansas's in the tournament. They're out. So this is a pretty tough preparation to lead into your conference and to lead into the NCAA tournament.
Williams Holiday collects another rebound. Deja Woodard, the transfer from Minnesota, misses that. Not quite the start that this Jackson State team had in the SWAC tournament final. They ran out to a very fast start, 17-4 lead against Alabama State in the finals.
And they're getting good looks, but they've really got to focus on getting it into Williams Holiday. That's their go-to player.
Afua so strong inside, draws the foul. She will go to the free throw line.
Yeah, Afua's, she's, we talked a lot about Williams Holiday. Afua's just as strong. Shoots through contact right here, gets with the body, and one.
So Amisha Williams Holiday picks up her first foul. Faustina Fua, 58% free throw shooter on the year, but finishes that three-point play.
She wants a three-point shot. Throw out that record. Throw out that percentage, Brenda.
You don't need to worry about percentages this time of year. It's just time to play.
Goodness, no.
Rogan short. One for eight for Jackson State, and quickly to the other end, Jailin Cherry and the LSU Tigers. A timeout on the floor for Tamika Reed. A 9-0 run for LSU, and the crowd is fired up. And a lot of fans here celebrating LSU leading 9-2 in the opening minutes. There was a St. Patrick's Day parade downtown or here in Baton Rouge today, and everybody coming out to celebrate the success of this team this year.
Well, just bring the party over into the PMAC, and that's what they're doing right now. Loud. They love these Tigers right here.
LSU hasn't hosted since 2014. Their last appearance in the NCAA championship was in 2018. But their last win in an NCAA championship game was in 2014. So the Tigers are hungry. Offensive rebound, yeah, and a foul committed on LSU. There was Amisha Williams Holiday for the rebound.
Yeah, I like that crump. Nice look. She's got a nice jumper. She elevates on it, and Williams Holiday did a good job of keeping the ball alive, giving them another possession.
Ryan Payne picked up her first foul. Williams Holiday, who averages over 19 points a game, hasn't had a shot attempt yet, but there's Jaria Covington into the game, the senior out of Starkville, Mississippi.
Yeah.
Ryan Payne with the travel.
Just trying to play a little too fast.
And a timeout called, and when we come back, Alexis Morris will be back on the court for LSU. Welcome back to Baton Rouge. LSU leading 9-4 against Jackson State. And we didn't know if we would see Alexis Morris, but she checked in right before we went for break. She sprained her MCL against Alabama on February 24th. Didn't play against Tennessee. Did not play in the SEC tournament. They were getting her ready for the NCAA, but she was playing some of her best basketball of the year right before the injury.
Yeah, she was, and this team really thrives on her and thrives on her ability to score. And when she was out, LSU struggled at times, so it's great to see her back and hopefully contributing to the Tigers.
I mean, they got the win at Tennessee and finished second in the SEC as, out of the timeout, Maya Crump knocks down a three-pointer to help out the Jackson State cause. A little 5-0 run for the Lady Tigers of Jackson State.
She's got to shoot that. She was up around the basket. She's got to make that play.
Luckett pushes it ahead over the top to Woodard. And Crump commits the offensive foul. And that's not good news for Jackson State because that's her second foul.
Yeah, Newby did a great job. You can't pass. You can't get up in the air and pass because LSU's really good at help side defense. And Newby came over and drew the charge.
So Crump will go to the bench. And and a new defense for Jackson State. Khayla Poynter organizes LSU. Afua fouled by Deja Woodard.
Solid. It was between her and the basket. You can't swat down on the ball. That's going to be a foul.
Well, the NCAA Men's Basketball Championship first round continues tonight on CBS, TBS, TNT, and True TV. For more information on tournament games and times and listings, go to NCAA.com. Afua connects on the free throw. She made one of two to give LSU the three-point lead. Fourth team foul already for Jackson State. Number one, Tyon Bowler onto the court for Jackson State. Covington off the window.
She's just really quick. She's quick off her first step, and that was a tough shot to finish.
Covington has scored 11 points for Jackson State twice in their last three games. Cherry, so good with that mid-range jumper.
Somebody better get on Cherry. She's feeling it right now.
Jackson State started a little shaky. 1 of 9 from the floor. They're 3 of their last 3 until that one. Inside. Autumn Newby misses. Afua is going to go to the free throw line yet again as LaMiracle Sims committed the foul.
Yeah, KP broke down the defense and had a great look, just missed it, but you got to finish it. And Afua finished up with an offensive rebound.
First foul on Sims, a 6'1 senior. Already 4 offensive rebounds for LSU. Afua makes the first free throw. Well, she has just gotten better and better throughout the course of her career and this season.
Well, she has, and I love that she steps up, and well, I was going to jinx her. She's hit free throws because she's not a great free throw shooter, but she got 1 out of 2.
Three-pointer by Deja Rogan.
Yeah, Deja Rogan, she shoot the three. She's super quick, but she's got great range from the three-point line.
Yeah, she's a 34% three-point shooter. She averages over 13 points a game. And it's Jackson State basketball. You know, the three ball can get you back in a hurry. LSU's only scored free throws on the last couple of possessions. Jackson State hit that three.
Yeah, they're 2 for 3 right now, and it keeps them in the game.
Jackson State 2 for 3, LSU 0 for 1. That's not a big part of their game, but Jackson State has the ability.
No, that's not her game. Coach Mulkey's not going to like that.
And just as you say that, a couple of subs ready to come in for LSU.
You know, the post needs to just kick it out. Just kick it out.
And KP going to the rim is fouled. So Awa Trazi and Hannah Gusters checking in for Autumn Newby and Afua. Faustine Afua will take a seat.
All right, Faustine, you've been killing it around the basket.
Covington commits the foul. Khayla Poynter at the free throw line. Her mom, Simone, in the audience.
Yeah, it's good to see Simone, and that's Nikki Fargus's sister, and just very supportive of Caleb, and I love seeing her. You know, she's a former official. Well, she had the stripes. I need to borrow her top.
I mean, you've tried to be an official over these last couple of games, so maybe you need to get her a whistle.
I know. I can't say I'm former. I could possibly say I'm trying to be present.
on LSU. But Khayla gets it honestly, and she comes from a family that has played a lot of basketball. Awa Trazi fouls on her first defensive possession, and then a carry called on Deja Rogan.
Yeah, good hesitation, just can't get your hand under the ball. Just keep the ball down. I like her hesitation. She's really making it difficult to defend. Just got to keep her hand on top of the basketball.
Ryan Payne over to Cherry to Pointer. Gusters out of that short corner against the zone. Tough shot. Trazi keeping it alive. And then a foul is called. LSU is in the bonus, so
yeah.
Free throws will be shot.
Well, this zone has really slowed LSU's attack down, and LSU standing a little bit more. But what's keeping them in the game is offensive rebounding.
You saw Jaria Covington going to the bench. She has two fouls. Trazi makes her first free throw. After this attempt, this will be 9 free throws already shot by LSU here in the first quarter.
Yeah, Jackson State's going to have to understand playing with your feet, not reaching, and not putting LSU at the free throw line.
Luckett finally going inside, and instead of shooting, Williams Holiday throws it away. That would have been her first shot attempt.
I think that's her first touch.
Yeah, go up with the ball,
yes.
Big girl inside.
Again, do what you do best. Score the basketball.
Pointer.
That's a great attack. She's gotten inside in the paint on the zone. That's nice.
There she is. That's what she does. Williams Holiday averages over 19 points a game. The player of the year in the SWAC conference gets her first basket of the game.
Well, she gets down the floor.
Last possession of the quarter, likely here for LSU. Pointer off the mark, and Jackson State is going to have some time for a shot at the basket. Luckett has it taken away by Ryan Payne, but a good first quarter for the champions out of the SWAC. The 14 seed hanging in with LSU early. The leading scorer for the Lady Tigers, Amisha Williams Holiday, on the season, finally gets her first basket of the game to draw within 2.
Wow.
Well, Jackson State, as they were represented well by their Tiger, started off 1-for-9 in this game, but they finished 5-of-8 to draw within 2. LSU, on the other hand, started 5-for-12, but they missed their last 6 shots.
Well, they have, and Jackson State's really picked up their defense and trying to limit them to 1 shot.
Williams Holiday falls to the floor, no foul called.
Well, she's getting double teamed, and she's going to have to kick it out and then repost, get a deeper bury, because they're not going to let Williams Holiday just sit down there and shoot turnaround jumpers.
Autumn Newby tried to set a screen on the interior of the zone and fell out of it. No call.
Yeah, they're not buying that. And shouldn't.
And Autumn Newby will take a seat along with Faustina Fua. So LSU has had the lead throughout the game. Jackson State has had a couple of possessions here where they could have tied or gone ahead. Rogan steps back, foot on the line.
Oh, great box out.
LSU finished second in the SEC. They lost to Kentucky in the SEC tournament. That's without Alexis Morris.
Yeah, they're Jackson State's doing a great. They're forcing LSU to make plays from the outside, and so is LSU. It's going to be a jump shooting game if both defenses have their way.
Bowler missed that shot. LSU has missed their last nine shots until that one.
All right, KP.
Well, you knew she could shoot better than that air ball she had earlier. She is a 36% three-point shooter.
Yeah.
Doesn't take a lot of them, but she is typically efficient.
Nice drive.
Nice rebound and put back. Tie on Bowler, the sophomore. Turnover.
So Coach Mulkey, she's not having it. If make a turnover and don't get it done, she's just subbing in and out.
Yeah, Kim Mulkey pretty much has a very low threshold for mistakes,
which I love. I mean, her expectation is to play the game hard but be smart. And throwing it to the defense down there is not smart to Coach Mulkey.
Not acceptable. Foul called that sends Deja Rogan to the free throw line. Rogan, a 71% free throw shooter. She misses the first. Well, the ESPN family of networks is your exclusive home for the NCAA Women's Championship. The Sweet 16 and Elite Eight will take place next weekend, starting March 25th. Then it's the Final Four for Minneapolis on April 1st. Followed by the national championship on April 3rd. One of two from the free throw line, and what a tournament it has been so far. We've had upsets. We had the dunk from Fran Belibi. We've had a lot of excitement.
A lot of close games, which I absolutely love.
And a strip and a steal by Deja Woodard. Again, Jackson State with an opportunity to tie, and they get it.
Yeah, great pass. I mean, that pass has to be on the money because LSU's defense was solid.
5-0 run for Jackson State. Cherry inside the three-point line.
Yeah, Cherry's getting it done right now for LSU. She's got 10 points. She's shooting a great percentage, but she's taking very good shots for her.
5 of 7 from the floor. And an answer back from Deja Woodard, the redshirt junior out of Mobile, Alabama. Autumn Newby swatted away with emphasis by Deja Woodard.
What? That's what happens when you have long arms. I mean, she came out from out of nowhere. Newby's thinking she's got an easy look, and Woodard just wowed.
Faustina Fua finally converts inside.
Nice knee, nice move, Faustine. Kept her composure, just pivoted, just made it look easy.
Luckett misses the three-point attempt.
Yeah, there's a battle going in between Newby and Williams Holiday.
Pointer with the floater, gets her own rebound and stick back.
Just keep an eye on that battle inside.
Ariana Hunter into the game, the freshman. Missed that three-point attempt, and then Tyon Bowler bumps into Cherry.
Yeah, and when you miss a shot, your coach should tell you, follow your shot. And what does she do? She follows her shot in for an easy bucket.
Pointer with 6 points. Cherry leading the way for LSU. She has 10, and Afua has 7 for the Tigers. Baseline jumper, good.
And nice play, nice design play, just screening up for the inbounder, and Caleb was ready.
So Jackson State had tied it at 21, and LSU on a 6-0 run, and the crowd glad to see it. The LSU crowd getting into it, as after that block earlier by Jackson State, there's a little contingent of Jackson State fans up here behind us. They were going crazy, and they were being louder than the LSU fans. So that kind of spurred on the LSU fans.
And I haven't seen this crowd since Simone Augustus and Sylvia Fowles were playing. So it is awesome to see.
Baseline jumper from LaMiracle Sims, her first basket of the game. Cherry has missed a couple now after starting 5 of her first 7, and Autumn Newby commits the foul on the rebound attempt. LSU having a tough time shaking Jackson State right now. They lead by 4. LSU leading by 4 in the second quarter, and before the game, all the crowd appreciating Kim Mulkey. What a year she's had, and this her first season, and you've known her for a long time.
Here's the deal, but Kim brings her energy, she brings her passion. You know, there's never a dull moment with Kim Mulkey, and she has proven herself at every level, as a player, as a coach. You know, and one thing I tell you about Kim, she'll let you know what she thinks, which I love. But I gotta borrow one of her sequin tops. I mean,
you think she'll let you borrow one of her jackets for Monday's game?
I may have to wrestle her for it. I don't know.
You see the national championships, the only person that has played for a national champion, and she has a national championship in the AIAW days and the first year of the NCAA 40 years ago, as Jackson State hits that jumper. She also was an assistant coach for Leon Barmer for one of those championships at Louisiana Tech, and then 3 as a head coach at Baylor.
Yeah, I just think she's a great competitor. And she's brought her competitive edge to this LSU Tiger team.
And she's liking the competitive edge from Faustine Afua here in the early going. 14 second chance points for LSU. Afua has 9 points.
And Kim's always working, and it doesn't have to be during, you know, it can be during a dead ball or a timeout, and she's just always teaching. She's also officiating right there, too.
Teaching, officiating.
Yeah.
Alexis Morris is back on the court. She only played 2 minutes in the first quarter, and her first action back after the injury, the MCL sprain on February 24th in the game against Alabama.
They're just trying to get some good looks against this zone, and Fatu's really been the savior for here. And Cherry.
Cherry now with 12 points. She's 6 of 10 from the field.
Yeah, she's feeling it.
Covington. Williams Holiday trying to keep it alive. Out in front, Cherry, she's got 14.
Yeah, that's a Jailin Cherry show right now. And Williams Holiday, you can't put it down, because LSU guards are going to come down there and swipe it. You just cannot put it down, because you're a focal point.
Jackson State needs to get the ball in the hands of Amisha Williams Holiday. She only has 4 points so far, and Cherry on her own 6-0 run. And she is fired. fired up, firing this crowd up. These players have got to just love this environment they're playing in today.
They are feeding off this energy, and Cherry is, she's delivering.
Largest lead of the game for LSU, fueled by Jailin Cherry.
And she's doing it all. That's just a jumper, and look at her. She's feeling the crowd, and the crowd loves it. Her team loves it. Coach Mokey loves it. She's bringing down the house right now.
Bringing the smile. 16 points, 8 of 12 from the field. Just a great, so much energy here at the PMAC.
Well, she's not really, she averages 9 points a game, and she's taken up the slack where Pointer hasn't really scored a whole lot. You know, Morris hasn't scored, so she's really taken up the slack for the perimeter players.
But Khayla Pointer has 8 points, 4 rebounds, and 4 assists.
Wow.
Crump is back into the game, and she breathes a sigh of relief because Maya Crump had just come back into the game with 2 fouls and got run over. She thought that might be her third, but instead the foul called on LSU on Khayla Pointer, and that's her first foul.
Did you see Wooder go up to get that rebound? Wow.
Williams Holiday being defended by Afua inside. LSU off to the races. Cherry yet again.
Who else?
And a foul on Khayla Pointer. That will send Kishana Luckett to the free throw line. Let's take a look at another fast break for LSU.
Well, it comes off a steal, and they're really good. Look how quick they get out. And Morse just passes ahead. Cherry's, she's playing today.
And she scored the last 8 points for LSU.
Yeah, Jackson State's got to find a way to score in this half court against this defense right now. LSU's doing a good job of making them take difficult shots.
Luckett, a 73% free throw shooter on the year, misses the first. Well, coming up at halftime, Degree in the studio, taking a look at all the action from a busy first round of games. Kelsey Riggs, Andrea Carter, and Monica McNutt in the studio. Can't wait to hear from them. Andrea Carter, a favorite of both yours and mine.
Yeah, I recruited Andrea. She's grown up. Well, doing a great job.
She and I worked a lot of games together a couple years ago, and she has done such a terrific job in the studio.
Yeah, I'm really proud of her.
Also, Monica and Kelsey, you all doing a good job,
like
too.
Yeah, they're doing a great job, too.
13-point lead for LSU, largest lead of the game, and a missed shot attempt, but a rebound and putback for LaMiracle Sims.
Boy, LaMiracle's really come up with really 2 solid rebounds and gotten 4 points from there.
It was a 2-point game as we started the second quarter. LSU has outscored Jackson State here in the second quarter, 25-14. With 1 minute remaining in the half. A delay of game warning on LSU. Maya Crump on the court. Just a quiet first half for the SWAC player of the year. Amisha Williams-Holiday being well defended inside by LSU. She gets the ball here, goes to work, blocked by Faustina Fua. And then it's turned over by LSU. Jackson State will have another possession.
Yeah, great, great block. Moved her body. Just moved her body, stayed between the ball and the basket.
Williams-Holiday, blocked again by Afua.
Yeah, Williams-Holiday's got to go somewhere with that dribble, but Afua's doing a great job at defending inside.
Alexis Morris has been on the floor. We haven't seen any shot attempts from her.
Well, she had need to because Cherry's doing everything.
That's true. Deja Rogan fouls Khayla Poynter. It's just the second team foul on Jackson State. Payne not wearing her face mask, dribbling the ball here. 3 seconds remaining. Morris kicks it off. Cherry.
Who else?
Oh. One of the rare misses for Cherry in the first half as she finishes the first half with 18 points. 9 of 13 from the field. LSU leading 41-28. It's time to go to the studio. Kelsey, take it away. Welcome back. Thanks for joining us here in Baton Rouge alongside Holly Warlick. I'm Brenda Van Lingen. Well, this is a two-point game at the end of the first quarter. What did LSU do to separate themselves?
Well, this game has gone back and forth, but they've really done a great job on Williams-Holiday, limiting her touches, much less scoring. But I tell you what, Jailin Cherry has stepped up and carried this LSU team. She is on fire. She's taking great looks and doing everything for her team.
Well, let's see how Jailin Cherry is achieving the impossible, brought to you by Adidas.
Yeah, Jailin Cherry is just shooting great shots for her. She's shooting threes. She's getting out on the break. She's coming in, and look here. She just pulls up on a dime, banks it in, getting the crowd going up. Hey, I'm excited for her because she is really, really having a super game right now.
She has 9 field goals made. The rest of the LSU team, only 8 field goals. And there's what Jackson State needs to do. Go inside to the player of the year in their conference, the SWAC, Williams-Holiday.
Well, here's what they did different, Bryn. They fed the ball from the high post, and there's no help. She ducked in and turned away from the defense. Great adjustment at halftime.
Starting lineup back out on the court for LSU. Ryan Payne on the baseline.
Yeah, good little pull up for Ryan Payne right there.
Starters back on the court for Jackson State also, as Luckett has her shot blocked, but Jackson State will have it under the basket. 20 seconds on the shot clock.
LSU's posts are big. You got to move them. Got to move them. And right there, you got to feed the ball from the high post there.
Over the top to Khayla Poynter. And whistled because Williams-Holiday was shaken up after that play. I don't know if we have a contact situation, but it looks like it. Immediately she went to the sideline.
And Coach Reed wasn't very happy about it. You see, you just got to move. There's just, it was from the ball. I think the ball hit her and knocked the contact out. It's solid defense. It's just going to be hard for Williams-Holiday to just turn and shoot.
Amisha Williams-Holiday is 6'4" and long arms, but she doesn't have a lot of players her size in the SWAC that she goes up against. Faustina Fuel, an inch taller at 6'5", and she's just had a hard time going right up over her.
And Faustine's doing a great job, just going straight up, moving her feet, making Williams-Holiday make a play, and she's done a great job of defending that.
A pass off and a foul committed on Jackson State, and a technical called on the bench on Tamika Reed after the foul was called. The first foul on Luckett, Luckett, Keshana.
And probably trying to get her team fired up, and she didn't like the no call down here, but it was from the ball, and obviously she didn't like this last call as well.
So Khayla Pointer will go to the free throw line. She makes the first. And Tamika Reed trying to fire up her troops. She was the SWAC coach of the year this year, leading Jackson State to an historic 18-0 mark in conference play. So Pointer makes the first two free throws, and she is going to stay for the follow-up as well. She was shooting the technical, and now the two shots on the foul.
And I will say this, Coach Reed has done a great job of building positive culture and building relationships for Jackson State.
So Pointer goes 2 for 4 from the free throw line. Tamika Reed, such great success and pushing Jackson State to the longest winning streak in the country. Stanford tied them yesterday, and Princeton moved up to 18 in a row with their win over Kentucky just moments ago.
Yeah, Princeton is a really dangerous team, and they spread the floor and they run a motion offense, and Carla Berube's done a great job there in getting her team into the second round of the tournament.
Welcome to our ESPN2 audience that is joining us. LSU, the number 3 seed in the Spokane region, up 47-30, now 47-32 over Jackson State. The representative out of the SWAC. It was a 2-point game after the first quarter, but Jailin Cherry went off in the second quarter. She's got 18 points. LSU was up by 13 at the half, and now they lead by 15. Cherry gets the rebound. Khayla Pointer steps into a 3-pointer.
Yeah,
and a foul on the rebound.
Yeah, I think the technical has gotten Jackson State a little fired up.
A technical was called just moments ago. Tamika Reed, the head coach for Jackson State, the SWAC coach of the year, protesting after a foul was called, and actually after a foul wasn't called in front of her against Jackson State. Those two things combined earned her a technical, and Jackson State a little more fired up these last couple of possessions.
Yeah, they don't look at the scoreboard. They're gonna play as hard as they can. They play discipline. They're going to take on their coach's personality, and right now they're not very happy.
Foul was called on Autumn Newby of LSU, her second foul. Deja Rogan at the line. Last season, she was the SWAC player of the year. This year, she was second team all conference, and she was the SWAC tournament MVP for the second year in a row, as she converts on the free throw. On this end, LSU started the quarter 2 for 2, but they've missed their last 3 shots.
And Jackson State's really have ramped up their defense right here.
And Luckett pokes it away from behind, and then the ball gets away from her on the fast break. Jackson State tries to get organized. How about that?
She just wanted to shoot a 3. She goes, I got this layup down, but I'm going to show you my skills from the arc.
Keshawna Luckett with the 3-pointer. Just her 22nd 3-pointer of the year, and a 7-0 run for Jackson State to draw within 10. Afua misses, trying to go over the player of the year this year in the SWAC, Amisha Williams-Holiday. Williams-Holiday has been held to just 6 points, but came up with a nice defensive play there.
Yeah, Holiday did what LSU's been doing to her. She just returned the favor.
And Payne stripped it away originally, but it got away from her, and it will be Jackson State basketball.
Ooh, this game is up and down.
And I agree with you that I think Jackson State playing with a little more fire right now after the technical called against Tamika Reed.
Absolutely.
A 7-0 run for the Lady Tigers of Jackson State since the technical. Jackson State, the number 14 seed. This is the best seed that they have had since back in the 80s. Last year, they were a 15 seed, and they played a Coach Mulkey-coached Baylor team. Cherry blocks it. Out to Crump. Crump buries the three, and it's a seven-point game.
Oh, wow. Are they trying to miss easy shots to kick out the threes?
It's certainly bringing the life. 10-0 run, and then who stops it but Khayla Poynter?
Yeah, I love that no call. I love KP's attack, but I love that no call.
Jaria Covington, the 5'5 senior from Starkville, Mississippi, with the basketball. Out to Luckett. She is a hometown girl from Jackson, Mississippi. Six on the shot clock. Covington blocked by Cherry. 3 seconds remaining on the shot clock.
Yeah, they've got to score quick in here. Do they got a chance to lob it to Williams Holiday?
There she goes to work, and yeah. She's fouled by Faustina Fua, and Kim Mulkey not happy about that call.
Yeah. Well, you know who was going to with 3 seconds.
It's the first foul on Faustina Fua. She's done a terrific job on Amisha Williams-Holiday so far.
Really has. She's done a great job on her. I'm not, you know, I think they called it with the body there.
Holiday now with 7 points. She has 21 double-doubles on the year. That ties for seventh best in the NCAA. She scored as many as 33 points earlier this year. She had a game where she had 21 rebounds.
Yeah, God.
She averages a double-double. Cherry back irons it.
Yeah, and they're trying to, they went to Cherry, and rightfully so. She's really played well and shot well in this game so far.
So the biggest lead for LSU was a 17-point advantage. Jackson State has trimmed that to 7. In traffic, Luckett gets her own rebound, dishes off to Williams. Holiday too strong.
Oh,
and Crump went up high and landed hard on
yes,
her backside.
Did.
And a foul called. The basket counts. And we will have a free throw when we come back.
Yeah, and it's an up and down, and what a game, and we're going back and forth. It's a battle right now.
Welcome back to Baton Rouge. It's a battle of the bands, a battle of the mascots, a battle of the Tigers. LSU leading 51-42 in the third quarter. We are in the Spokane region. The winner of this game will go on to play Ohio State on Monday. Let's look over at the Bridgeport region, where there have been an upset. Princeton knocking off the SEC tournament champion, Kentucky. USF beat Florida out of the SEC to advance to play UConn.
Well, Princeton's
UCF,
a hot,
excuse me.
Princeton's a hot team right now, and that's going to be a good Indiana team. But the UCF thinks, you know what, we thought we saw the last of UConn when they left the American Conference, but listen, UCF knows UConn and will be ready to battle.
Coach Abe's team winning the American this year, and
yeah, for the first time. So congratulations to her and congratulations to Advance. She beat a tough Florida team.
Crump fouled on the block out by Ryan Payne.
See that?
Third foul on Payne. Kim Mulkey looking up at the big screen here to see if she can see what happened.
Yeah.
Fourth team foul. Crump.
You know, Coach Mulkey can look up, but if she points to it, the officials are supposed to give her a technical. So she said, I didn't say anything. I was just looking up.
Crump making both free throws.
She's drawing a lot of tension over there with the sparkles on her jacket.
You're just jealous.
I sure am. She can wear it. Looks good on her.
Payne steps back. Big rebound. What a rebounder. Deja Woodard.
She's got, is she on a pogo? It looks like she's on a pogo stick. You remember those old pogo sticks?
I do. She has an amazing vertical
Golly.
Leap. Nice pass to set up Williams Holiday.
That's how you get her the ball.
And now it's a five-point game. LSU led by as many as 17, and it's a 16-4 run for Jackson State.
And it started with the technical.
Whistle and a foul on Williams Holiday. Williams Holiday now with 10 points on the setup from Deja Rogan.
Yeah, just gets up, attacks, and has to draw some help. And so when you draw help, you leave that post player wide open. Somebody didn't drop down and take care of Williams Holiday. That's the easiest 2 points she's gotten all day.
Mm-hmm. On the other end, she picked up her second foul, sending Khayla Pointer to the free throw line. Pointer misses the first. This is the closest Jackson State has been in quite a while, as they got down by as many as 17 points. And KP makes the second. Deja Rogan buries the three.
Wow. I was just going to say, man, Jackson State's being really patient with their offense, and Rogan hits a big-time three.
5 of 8 from three-point range is Jackson State.
Nice bury. Just a deep bury.
But you can't finish, and Williams Holiday there for the rebound. Holiday, Williams Holiday now with 10 points and 8 rebounds. Jackson State has climbed back in this game since the technical foul was called on Coach Tamika Reed. Another three-point attempt. Covington gets it, and it's a tie ball game.
Here we go.
Alexis Morris, that's her first shot attempt. Autumn Newby misses. And Williams Holiday, one rebound away from a double-double.
Great rebound, but couldn't finish. That's two on her.
Nice dish off inside. Technical called on Deja Woodard after she scored it because she turned around and yelled and taunted at LSU. But what a run for Jackson State. This is the first lead since they led 2-0 in this game.
Yeah. I love it. I love her spunk. Just got to control that part of it.
So now the basket should count because the basket scored and then she turned around and yelled, and that's where the technical was called.
Two shots, bust the ball.
So Alexis Morris goes to the free throw line after the technical was called on Woodard. And the ball game is all tied up. But think back to that first technical as the Jackson State fans are very happy with the way their team has played. Tamika Reed at the 8:44 mark earlier this quarter was called for a technical. Since then, Jackson State has outscored LSU 24-7. And
Woodard just showing some emotion right now.
Alexis Morris steps back. Well, it looked straight on, but it was short. And it will stay LSU basketball. So Kim Mulkey had Alexis Morris shoot those free throws just to give her a chance to see the ball go through the basket. As she's had limited time here in her first game back since the injury in the second to last regular season of the game. Here's Alexis Morris going to try to turn it on. Misses.
And yeah, now and a good look.
And
good look.
And a double-double for Williams-Holiday as she has 10 points and 10 rebounds. That's her 22nd double-double of the year.
Boy, but it's been a hard struggle for her.
She's fouled, though, by Hannah Gusters.
She's had to work for every point. I think there's one basket she got off of her man helping, and it was easy. But everything else has just been a battle.
Amisha Williams-Holiday, what a story. She started her college career at Mississippi State, decided it wasn't for her, decided she was going to quit basketball, get out of it completely. But Tamika Reed had recruited her from the junior college that she was at, Hines College, and she checked in on Williams-Holiday. She said she really wanted her to come play for her. And she got Williams-Holiday to say yes, but then she shared that she was pregnant, and Coach Reed stuck with her through that time. Williams-Holiday has done a terrific job as a mother and a student. And she is a player of the year in the SWAC conference.
Well, you gotta love that story. Getting an opportunity to get your degree.
And a foul on the floor as Williams-Holiday and Autumn Newby got tied up. And it's, I believe the foul is on Autumn Newby, her third.
Yeah, and Autumn Newby needs to be careful because she's reacting the same way that Woodard reacted, so you got to be real careful right here.
What a third quarter for this Jackson State squad. The season numbers for Williams-Holiday, so impressive.
Yeah, I've been really impressed with her. She's been frustrated, but she, you know what? She continues to play defense.
And she's continued to battle.
Absolutely.
As she now has 12 points and 11 rebounds. And Jackson State has a two-point lead over the number three seed LSU. Here comes Jackson State. They push ahead and score it to go up by four. Tylan Bowler with the basket in transition.
God, was that quick. That was off. That was a rebound and run. Then you can't leave Morris open.
And a foul called on on Williams-Holiday, I believe, as Alexis Morris was going up for the three.
Yeah, Jackson State was trying to jump into a zone because LSU was flattening out and Morris had to come out. Williams-Holiday had to come out and guard Morris. Not a good foul.
So Alexis Morris at the free throw line. She has not made any field goals today, but she's 4 for 4 from the free throw line. 5 for 5 to draw LSU within one. 4 seconds on the clock. Deja Rogan gets all the way to the basket. Ooh. No foul called, no basket made, and that's the way the quarter will end. As Autumn Newby is slow to get up, Deja Rogan is slow to get up. But Jackson State outscored LSU 30-16 this quarter. That's the most points that LSU has given up in a quarter this year. Jackson State taking a one-point lead to the fourth quarter. Welcome back to Baton Rouge. What a game we have for you as Jackson State, the number 14 seed, up on LSU 58-57 as we start the fourth quarter. And Jackson State's AD is in attendance, Ashley Robinson. What a time for him, hiring Deion Sanders. Their football program wins a SWAC championship, gets to a bowl game. They hire Mo Williams as their men's basketball coach. And he hired Tamika Reed to lead this team, and what a job she has done at Jackson State.
Well, all three are great hires, but Tamika Reed, just watching her team and talking to her, she has done a phenomenal job. These kids play hard. They've got her spirit. They got her spunk.
And check this out. LSU was leading 47-30. When Tamika Reed was called for a technical. As Khayla Pointer gets the lead back for LSU. But since that technical was called, when Jackson State was down by 17, they've outscored LSU 28-12 since then.
Yeah, it's been a roller coaster. And I look, she did what she wanted to do, got her team fired up. They've done it with shooting threes, attacking the basket, but they've really done a solid job on the defensive end and rebounding and not allowing LSU to get second chance points during that stretch.
So Alexis Morris commits the foul and sends Maya Crump to the free throw line. Crump has 10 points. She's short on that one. Williams Holiday, the player of the year in the SWAC, leads the way for Jackson State with 12 points and 11 rebounds. Crump, the only other player in double figures, as she connects on the second free throw. And it's tied. Khayla Pointer and the officials pointing the way of Jackson State. Kim Mulkey and several LSU players are saying it's LSU's ball, but it's Jackson State's possession.
Yeah,
the officials right there underneath.
Williams Holiday up over. Oh. Afua can't get that one to go.
That was down and just popped right on back up. And LSU KP's just taking it to the basket. She's just being really smart, clearing out the lane, setting a little simple ball screen on the wing and letting Khayla Pointer go to work.
So Khayla Pointer will go to the free throw line. This team, LSU, was really buoyed by the play of Jailin Cherry in the first half. She had 18 points in the first half. She still has 18 points, so hasn't scored. Khayla Pointer has 17, and Faustine Afua has 11 points. Luckett committed the foul. It's her third. Now Pointer, now 4 of 9 from the free throw line. So her mom Simone looking on in concern right now.
And Kayla struggled a little bit at the free throw line, so I'm sure that's why Coach Mulkey put Morris at the line for the technical fouls.
So the free throw puts LSU up by one. Maya Crump, a transfer from Houston. Deja Woodard inside is a transfer from Minnesota. Crump rises up and splashes home a three.
That kid can elevate. Wow.
Jackson State representing the SWAC, representing the HBCUs, trying to get their first NCAA tournament win, trying to get the first win for the SWAC.
Looked like she got away with a little push off too. Yeah, Woodard. Yeah, both of them. Yeah, they're both.
The official has to step in.
They're both a little chippy right now.
Our officials today, Roy Gobain, Ifiwana Seals, Cheney Munich, or Minch, excuse me. And they come together as the players, as you mentioned, Holly, just getting a little chippy, a little too much talk.
Yeah, and Winter's got to get, both of them have got to get their emotions under check right now. Yeah, and it's just, you watch, she pushes her. So what is Woodard, you can't react, because guess what? You're going to get caught for the reaction. And that's what she did.
The double foul called. Afua's, that's her second. Deja Woodard, that's her third. Jackson State leading by two.
Oh, got her on the arm.
What a smart play by Williams-Holiday. She felt the defender going across her arm, and she just raises up and goes for the shot.
And she did. She grabbed her arm.
And that's the third foul on Khayla Poynter.
I just think it wasn't intended for Khayla. She just reached out, and she caught her arm.
Amisha Williams-Holiday at the free throw line makes the free throw. She's 5 of 7 on the day, a 67% free throw shooter. And she makes them both as Williams-Holiday, who just got married this past June, now with 14 points and 11 rebounds.
Yeah, they're going to ISO Cherry. Cherry here.
Cherry hasn't scored this half, and Williams-Holiday grabs another rebound. Jackson State made its way through the SWAC tournament.
Yeah.
As Crump is fouled on the three.
Yeah, she needs to be careful too. Yeah.
Cherry is frustrated. She reacts. Jackson State's team comes around Crump to make sure that Crump doesn't react.
No, she just got her with her body, and you cannot react to the. She's lucky. She is lucky. She did not get a technical. She got a warning.
Yeah, there have been enough technicals called in this game, and coaches stepping in to kind of calm things down.
Yeah.
You have to be careful not to react that way right now.
She's extremely, extremely lucky.
Crump is at the free throw line. Maya Crump makes the first free throw. She's got 15. All tournament team in the SWAC tournament. A transfer from the University of Houston, where last year she averaged over 10 points a game in the American Conference.
Yeah, she's been solid today. I mean, she's 15 points, 5 rebounds. Has really lifted this team up at the right time.
Yeah, she had a big game in their championship game against Alabama State. She had 22 points, 8 of 11 from the field. And she's got 16 points now. 7-0 run for Jackson State. Afua knocks in a much needed jumper, and Kim Mulkey jumps up for a timeout. 6:48 remaining. Jackson State looking for their first NCAA win in history. It would be a big upset. LSU trails by 4. LSU led by as many as 17 points in the second half of this game. Jackson State now leads by 4 with 6:48 remaining in the game. An upset in the making, possibly. Let's take a look at our Spokane region bracket. On the other side of the bracket, the number 2 seed Texas advanced to the second round. They'll play Utah. The winner of this game will play Ohio State on Monday.
Yeah, and Ohio State took care of business against Missouri State. And so then you see Jackson State just hanging on with LSU.
A 14 seed has never beaten a 3 seed in the NCAA women's tournament. There's so much history on the line today. Jackson State looking for their first NCAA tournament win. The SWAC as a conference looking for their first tournament win. And Khayla Pointer, and this is big trouble for LSU. Pointer picks up her 4th foul.
Yeah. Kayla, we got to be smarter than that. And Kim's upset about it, but she should be upset with Kayla because that was a foul.
Williams Holiday misses the first free throw. She's 6 for 9 from the line today. Jackson State as a team, 15 of 22. But she makes the second. 5-point lead for Jackson State.
Yeah, Jackson State's gone to a zone.
Cherry steps into it. Finally, first basket of the second half for Jailin Cherry. After Cherry was so good in the first half, she had 18 points and was a big spark for LSU.
Uh-oh.
3-pointer from the corner, Maya Crump.
Uh-oh.
Maya Crump now with 19 points.
And that zone didn't last long. Jackson State's back into their man-to-man.
Cherry waiting for the screen, rises up, no. Afua rebounds and Crump fouls.
Yeah, good rebound by Afua.
Already in this game, 8 3-pointers for Jackson State.
See, Afua had to come out and Crump was just, she was waiting on the ball. She had already set.
Jackson State 8 of 11 from 3-point range. LSU 1 for 8. Biggest lead of the ball game for Jackson State.
Yeah, Jackson State's pretty calm right now, taking solid looks at the getting solid looks at the basket.
Afua off the mark. And there's Deja Rogan, the smallest player on the court, to bring down the rebound.
That's a great look. Afua, that's a great look. Just didn't go down.
Crump behind the back, hounded by Payne, and Payne grabs her to pick up the foul.
Yeah, you just can't.
Jackson State has outscored LSU 44 to 24 in the second half. Are we on the verge of history here in Baton Rouge? Well, the sonic boom of the South has something to make noise about right now. Jackson State on the verge of history. If they can hang on here in the last 4 minutes and 54 seconds, once again, LSU led by 17 points, 47 to 30, when Tamika Reed picked up a technical. And since then, Jackson State has outscored LSU 42 to 17 to take this lead in the fourth quarter.
And this young lady at the line has just been, she's been awesome today. She's 4 for 4 from the three-point line. You know, she has 2 assists, 5. She's just playing a solid game right now for Jackson State.
You know, and she picked up 2 fouls very early in this game and had to go to the bench. And so the fact that she's been resilient and come back and now has led Jackson State to a 10-point lead, their largest of the ball game, with under 5 minutes remaining. Faustina Fua going to work.
Oh.
Fouled by Amisha Williams-Holiday. That's huge, because that's the 4th foul on the player of the year in the SWAC that sends Afua to the free throw line.
Yeah, just backed her in, and Williams-Holiday, I think she probably didn't just go straight up, and we'll see it right here. Yeah, just put her, she keeps her hands up, she's fine, but the minute you break that plane, they're gonna call a foul. And watch LSU. They're going to speed up the game here a little bit. They're going to press. We'll see how Jackson State handles their press.
So Williams-Holiday goes to the bench. Faustina Fua can cut it to a 7-point deficit, but misses. Oh, boy.
All right. It's all right.
The tempers have been flaring, and neither player wanted to let go of that ball, and both go to the floor hard.
Yeah.
Possession arrow, Jackson State.
Yeah, I mean, they're both, as you said, they're not letting go of the ball. They're going to play to the whistle.
Awatrazi and LaMiracle Sims, neither one wanting to let go. Covington over the top to Sims.
Yeah, good press, good pressure, taking some time off the clock.
Rogan working on Kayla Pointer, who has 4 fouls. Crump lets it get away, throws it up, and it's going to be a shot clock violation. 21 points for Crump, and that's her first missed three-pointer of the game. As you mentioned, she was 4 for 4 from beyond the arc, and a desperation heave is her first miss.
Well, as Jackson State wants to use the clock, they want to make sure they still get a good look, and LSU did a great job of pressing, getting the clock down low, and then forcing them to take a bad shot. And they're just going to clear out for the inside right now, just overload.
Cherry missing everything, and Ryan Payne can't save it.
Well, hey, Cherry, that's a good look, because you have led this team and kept this team in check, so don't put your head down.
Cherry has 20 points. She's 10 of 21 from the field. Kayla Pointer with 18, Afua with 15, but they're down. Maya Crump leading the way for Jackson State. Approaching 3.5 minutes remaining. And a foul called as Luckett drives in, and it's going to be a foul on Luckett. Three LSU defenders were there to greet her.
Yeah, LSU does a great job of help. Well, right here, yeah, they help. Look, they're right there. There's 3 of them. Take your pick.
LSU has to overcome this 8-point deficit. Afua there to clean it up. It's a 6-point game. And a timeout called, LSU. So LSU led by as many as 17 points. Jackson State came back. They led by 10 points at 74-64. And now LSU has scored the last 4 points. We are on the threshold of history if Jackson State can hold on. 14 seeds are 0-111 in the NCAA tournament.
Yeah, a tough task. And they've done a great job. And now LSU's being really aggressive in attacking the basket. And they're pressing. And so Jackson State down here, they're trying to use the clock and get a good look. Last two possessions, they have not gotten a good look.
So what does Jackson State need to do to keep this momentum going, to keep things on their side?
Well, just keep moving the ball side to side, penetrating towards them, getting good looks. You don't have to get deep in the clock. You've got the lead. Don't let LSU slow you up and take a bad shot. But then LSU, but down here, they've got to keep LSU in front of them. Kayla Porter's doing a great job attacking the basket, and Fatu's cleaning up her misses right now.
21 games in a row this Jackson State team has won. They went 18-0 in SWAC. They won three games in the tournament as Tamika Reed, the SWAC Coach of the Year, talks to her team with a six-point lead with 3:20 remaining. Her son Carlin Reed is on the bench with her. Her nine-year-old son, as she wants her team to go out and finish what they've been able to do. LSU has other plans as their loud home crowd here cheers them on. Ah. And LSU steals it.
Just threw it up in the air.
Pointer scores it. Six straight points for LSU. And Khayla Pointer will go to the free throw line.
Yeah, you know that was going to happen because this team has ridden on KB's shoulders the whole time. And what does she do? She gets a steal. Not a great decision. And attacks the basket. Draws the foul.
So the foul was called on Deja Woodard. That's her fourth foul. And Tamika Reed calls a timeout. Jackson State timeout. LSU on a 6-0 run with an opportunity for a free throw as Tamika Reed gathers her squad around her.
Well, she burned a timeout, and she felt the need because she felt the momentum obviously swinging towards LSU.
And that was not a good pass inbounds for the turnover. It was right after a timeout.
Well, she could almost, when she got the ball inbounds, she could have just dribbled up the sideline. But LSU is causing them to slow down, to hesitate. Jackson State just needs to stay in attack mode. Just attack.
Kim Mulkey has her team gathered around. Kim Mulkey hasn't lost a first-round game in the NCAA tournament since her first season at Baylor.
Yeah, and that was a long time.
That was the 2000-2001 season. So losing in the first round is not something Kim Mulkey's teams typically do.
Yeah, and she's not used to that. No.
So 3:10 remaining. Khayla Pointer at the line. Khayla has struggled. 5 of 10 from the free throw line, but she buries that one, and it's a three-point ball game. And a steal.
Wow.
Cherry scores it. It's a one-point game. And a technical, I believe, called on Covington. Let me see, sort this out here.
Yeah.
The officials are coming together to sort this out because I'm not sure what happened, and Kim Mulkey is not happy, so maybe there was a call against LSU. Let's see what happens here.
Yeah, I think she grabs the ball.
Oh, remember earlier in the game, LSU was given a warning for delay of game.
Yeah.
You can't take the ball out if your team scores and tap it out of the way. They got a delay of game call earlier in the game. That's a warning.
We have a delay of game on 10 White. It is a technical foul. 2 plus the ball, and that is her fifth personal foul.
That's a great call by the official because she did give her a warning. That's by the book, and she has to call that by the book.
Kim Mulkey can't believe it, but that is the rule book. That's the rule. It doesn't happen very often.
No.
You can't. They. It's in the rule book so that you can't slow down play and knock
Correct.
The ball out of bounds. So LSU had gotten a warning, and you you saw Ryan Payne, after the made shot, she grabs it, and I think she was just trying to be helpful and throw it to the referee. Watch here as Ryan Payne grabs it, and she just throws it to the referee.
Yeah, it's by the rule. You can't do it. Now, if they hadn't done it earlier, they would have had a warning. But
that's right.
Got a warning, got to call it.
So because she gets called for the technical, that's her fifth foul.
Yeah.
And Ryan Payne is out of the game. So Maya Krupp goes to the free throw line.
This place is just loud.
And Krupp misses both of them, up one. She's 7 of 11 from the free throw line. But Jackson State will get the ball to inbound, up one, but a missed opportunity for Maya Krupp and Jackson State.
Yeah. I mean, this environment, she's probably never been in this environment before.
The crowd is chanting LSU. Covington goes inside to Williams. Holiday is blocked by Afua. Here comes Khayla Poynter all the way to the paint and a blocking foul.
Wow.
And Khayla Poynter will go to the line with an opportunity to tie and take the lead.
That's a tough call right there. Oh. Tough call.
So the foul is called on Covington, her third. Khayla Poynter, 6 of 11 from the free throw line today. She's got 21 points. And she ties it with that free throw. Her mom, Simone, looking on. And the lead for LSU. It's an 11-0 run for LSU after they were down 74-64. From the corner, Rogan misses.
Yep.
LSU has held Jackson State scoreless since the 5:28 mark. Cherry from the baseline, bucket. She's got a career high 24 points, and she's got this crowd on its feet. A 13-0 run for LSU.
Yeah, and who else but Cherry? She's done it all today. And what does she do? She scores. She wants some love from the crowd.
LSU led by 17 points early in the third quarter. A technical was called on Tamika Reed. Her team stormed back. Jackson State took a 10-point lead with 4:54 remaining. They were on the verge of a historic win, and LSU has answered back with a 13-0 run.
I would, Krupp hasn't gotten the ball in a while, so I'd watch, see how.
Covington has it blocked by Afua.
Wow.
Covington tried to knife her way into the lane, but Afua was having none of that. And Khayla Poynter says there's some moisture on the floor that needs to be wiped up for safety. Williams Holiday is back in the game. Remember, Williams Holiday has the four fouls for Jackson State. Here she comes, blocked by Afua, blocked by Khayla Pointer. Alexis Morris comes away with it.
Wow, what a hustle play by Khayla Pointer. Just kept the ball alive, and great block, saved the possession.
Kim Mulkey says to Khayla Pointer, use as much time as you can before you start the play. Six on the shot clock. Khayla Pointer rises up, bounces three times, and Jackson State with an opportunity. Jackson State has made 8 of 13 from three-point range today, but they take it right at the rim, and a foul is called.
That's very smart, attacking the basket. Hadn't been able to get a good look, so they just attacked the basket.
Afua picks up the foul, but what a day. Faustine Afua has had 17 points and 14 rebounds. But she commits the foul. Afua has three. And Keshawna Luckett goes to the line. She has 6 points on the day. She's one of two from the free throw line.
Yeah, 73% free throw shooter here.
Luckett makes the first. It's a two-point ball game. Long, skying up as Woodard. She ties it! She ties it on the offensive rebound and put back.
Well, what a rebound!
We talked about the hops that Deja Woodard has, and she showed them off there.
Wow, she just jumped over.
Khayla Pointer straightaway three, nails it!
Wow!
26 points for Khayla Pointer.
Oh, wow.
Williams Holiday can't connect.
What a game.
What a game. There's about an 8-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. 3-point lead for LSU. Luckett commits the foul. Luckett will foul out with that and go to the bench. 7 points, 5 rebounds, 2 assists for Keshawna Luckett, but this might be the game-winning shot.
Ice in her veins. Ice in her veins. Didn't hesitate one bit.
Pointer now 2 of 5 from beyond the arc. Morris, that's her first miss. She was 5 for 5 from the free throw line. This one makes it a 2-possession game. Jackson State calls a timeout to advance it down 4. It's time now for our Capital One rewarding performance, and it is Khayla Pointer. What a game she has had for LSU.
Boy, she's done a little bit of everything. 8 assists, 8 rebounds, 26 points. Just done a phenomenal job. But that, the last shot couldn't have been better scripted. Didn't hesitate. Again, ice in her veins.
That shot put LSU up by 3. Her mom looking on, so proud.
Got her KP3 shirt on.
You have known her for a long time.
Yeah, I've known Khayla Pointer since she was a little baby and just watched her grow and Nikki Farguson was here, brought her in, and she's just grown and blossomed. And right here, could be the game winner.
And this was her mom's reaction.
Yeah.
The score was tied on an offensive rebound by Deja Woodard. And the biggest shot of the game, Khayla Poynter drains the three to go up three. Alexis Morris made a free throw. LSU up by four. Now Jackson State down four with 23.9. What are you expecting?
Yeah, I think Crump needs to hit a three right here real quick.
And there she goes. Almost got it. Trazi tips it. Khayla Poynter grabs it. They're just playing keep away right now at 11.3 seconds on the clock. Boy, Crump had a look, though, for Jackson State.
Yeah, she did. You knew it was going to her. She had a great look.
Maya Crump, the transfer from Houston, has 21 points. She made 4 of 6 today from the three-point arc, but couldn't connect on that. That would have drawn them within one. Woodard fouls out.
Yeah, this was not an easy trip for LSU. They had to battle the whole game and looked like they were comfortable, and then Jackson State fought back, and what a game.
LSU up 83-77. Covington, short. Well, Jackson State almost pulled off the improbable, but LSU closed strong and advanced to the second round. Survive and advance. That's exactly what LSU did today.
Absolutely. What a great game. Great atmosphere. Great for women's basketball.
Jackson State had gone up by 10 with under 5 minutes remaining, and LSU closed on a 19-3 run as Kim Mulkey and Tamika Reed come together at half court.
Wow. Yeah, and that's just Kim showing her a lot of respect, because Kim knows the game was right on the line.
LSU survives and advances to the second round. They win 83-77 over the 14 seed Jackson State. LSU will play Ohio State in the second round.
Right up there.
LSU will play Ohio State on Monday in the second round of the NCAA tournament. And now we are joined by Khayla Poynter. Khayla, wow. You were down by 10 points with under 5 minutes remaining. What did it take? You guys went on a 19-3 run to close this game and win. What did it take?
Oh, man. I'm still dancing. Just grit, honestly. Jackson State is a great team, man. Kudos to them. They played a great game. We knew it was going to be a dogfight the whole game. But, I mean, we got a lot of seniors on our team. Seniors, we've been thriving the whole year. And we're in that huddle, like, it's win or go home. Do we want to keep playing or do we want to go home? Do we want to take his jersey off for the last time? And we just figured we'd buckle up the last 4 or 5 minutes. We had plenty of time left. They went on their run, and we just had to go on ours. And I'm just happy, you know, we're still dancing.
Yeah, Khayla, the game is tied. You have the ball. They throw you the ball. You're at the three-point line. Tell me your thought process as you – you let that three fly.
Oh, man, I work on those shots every day. I've been obviously getting up shots. You know, we've been off for like 2 weeks. It's just rhythm. I, you know, caught the ball, shot it with confidence, and, you know, I want to take the shot for my team, and I'm happy it went in.
Well, this is the first win for LSU in the NCAA tournament since 2014. Your first opportunity to win an NCAA tournament game. What does this mean for you personally and for LSU?
Oh, man, it's special. We, you know, this is our second time being in a tournament. We made our first freshman year, but, you know, we lost in the first round. So, you know, we're happy to be here. We're happy we get to play another game. We have another one here on our home court on Monday. So, you know, just try to protect home court. It was a scare there. Again, great Jackson State team. But I'm happy, you know, we won and we're still dancing, baby.
And what about this crowd today?
Oh, they're the best fans in the world. We knew they were going to show out for us. You know, they give us momentum. We feed off their energy. And, you know, I'm happy to be able to play in front of them every night.
All right. Congratulations, Khayla. Go celebrate with your teammates.
Thank you. Thank you.
LSU with an 83-77 victory. They went on a 19-3 run to close the game. And now they will advance to the second round to face Ohio State.